Hello and welcome to the second of the two coast revision sessions. So this is revision session number two, management of coasts. This is a fairly brief keynote presentation. Just a few things to remember again. Your exam is worth 50% of your final grade, so you must revise. There are three sections. You must answer one question from each section, and you may have used different case studies. So, management of coasts. These are the key questions that we're going to have a look at today. What are the human and physical reasons for managing the coastline? In what ways can we protect the coastline? And what is the result of the management schemes? So, first off then, human and physical reasons to protect the coastlines. So, at some places there are more human reasons, and at other places there are more physical reasons. It depends on where you're looking. So under human, these are what we would class as social and economic reasons. So social reasons being things that affect people, and economic being monetary reasons. So a social reason, a risk of death, or risk of destruction of lives, the risk of housing loss, loss of jobs, loss of tourism and businesses. So you can see that jobs, tourism, businesses is all economic. Moving on to physical reasons then, your environmental reasons. The risk of affecting ecosystems, places with high salt concentrations is quite toxic to a lot of animals. It can kill organisms. And at any site of special scientific interest, if it's threatened by coastal erosion, it needs to be protected. So some management strategies then. These are hard engineering strategies. So you have seawall, riprap, groynes, revetments, gabions and breakwaters. Okay, these hard engineering, they're man-made structures built to control the flow of the sea and reduce flooding and erosion. Soft engineering, these schemes are set up using the knowledge of the sea and its processes to reduce the effects of flooding and erosion, like beach replenishment and managed retreat. So in your beach replenishment, you're just physically dumping more sediment onto the beach to make sure that the waves can't impact on the coastline. And your managed retreat is removing an existing defence, allowing the land behind it to flood. These soft engineering methods are a lot more sustainable, which means the strategies meet the needs of people today without stopping future generations getting what they need. If we just move back onto the hard engineering, hopefully we all know what each of these are. We've covered them in the coursework that we did on the Holderness coastline. So if you think about your sea wall at Bridlington, it's a wall made out of hard material like concrete that reflects waves back to sea. It prevents erosion on the coast and it also acts as a barrier to prevent flooding. However, it creates strong backwash which erodes under the wall, which means the wall continuously, every few years, has to be maintained. Very, very expensive. If we look a little bit further down to riprap, these are boulders that are piled up along the coast. They obviously absorb the energy of the waves. It reduces erosion and flooding. The only thing with these is that they can be moved around by strong waves, so they need to be replaced. Again, it's money. The groynes, if you move a little bit further down, they're wooden or stone fences that are built at right angles to the coast and they trap material transported by longshore drift. So when they trap the material, it creates a bigger beach which can take the impact of the waves. They absorb the energy of the waves so it doesn't erode the coastline. So they create wider beaches, they slow the waves and they give protection from flooding and erosion. However, they do starve beaches further down the coast of sand, making them narrower and increase the rate of erosion a little bit further down the coast, creating floods. Again, moving on, revetments are slanted structures made of concrete, wood or rocks built at the foot of the cliffs. They absorb the wave energy and so reduce erosion. They're very similar to sea walls. They're very expensive to build and they create, again, strong backwash that erodes under the barrier. They need to be maintained a lot. Gabions, second to last. They're rock-filled cages built at the foot of cliffs, and again they absorb the wave energy, and by doing that they reduce the erosion. They look ugly, they're horrible. Finally, breakwaters. They're concrete blocks or boulders that are deposited on the seabed, just off the coast. They force waves to break offshore so that their erosive power is reduced before they reach the shore. These are very expensive and can be damaged by storms and need to be replaced if there's really strong waves that damage them. Okay, if we have a look at our case study then, the coastal management, we're looking to the Holderness coastline. Now again, you might have done a different case study, that doesn't matter. I've just followed the ones that have been put in the revision guide. So this can be found on page 26 of your revision guide. Okay, so hard engineering strategies have been used at the Holderness coastline. If we look down from the map top to bottom, we start at Bridlington at the top, so it's just near Flamborough Head. So a seawall and groin has been built at Bridlington. The seawall and riprap and wooden groins have been built at Hornsey, the rock groins at Mapleton, groins and seawalls and riprap at Withensea, groins and riprap protect the east side of Spurnhead. The strategies are locally successful but lead to problems elsewhere, so there's conflict further down the coast. If we have a look particularly at a case of a lady called Sue Earle, if you Google that you'll be able to bring up her case in a little video and she explains to you what's happened to her house. So again, the results of coastal management, some positive, some negative. So we've just said a minute ago that the protecting a coastline can result in problems further down the coast. So places can be starved of sediment, so higher rates of erosion can be produced, and lots of conflict can arise. Again, think about the case of Sewell. That concludes our revision of coastal management, and I hope all of your other revision goes to plan.